Hello everyone! So today I'm going to be breaking down how my stream setup works, mostly because I'm about to change all of it. But this video is made for those of you who are interested in streaming, don't have a ton of money, maybe already own a MacBook, a TV, and a Switch, and the rest is pretty simple. You can buy the rest of these pieces probably for about $200. That includes your capture card. Let's get into it. We're going to start out with talking about the hardware that I use, so the physical chunky things you can hold on to. I pretty much only stream Switch gameplay. This setup is really just built for if you are streaming a console, streaming gameplay on your MacBook while you play the game on your MacBook can be really intensive. I found that's something my MacBook cannot handle. That might depend on your model, its processing power, its available memory, all of that. I have a refurbished early 2015 MacBook Pro. Mine has a 2.7 gigahertz dual core Intel Core i5. I hope that made sense to who it needs to make sense to. Basically, it has 128 gigabytes of memory, not including software. That is an abysmal amount. Always get more memory, invest in more memory. My phone has the same amount of memory as my laptop. That's not good, especially if you want to be doing any sort of video editing, photo editing stuff, along with streaming, if you want to turn YouTube into a thing for you. But in terms of the processing power, I run Final Cut Pro on my laptop with no problem. Literally the only issues that I have with running things on my laptop really comes up with memory and not having enough space, and my computer can't run well because it is like full to the brim with a Final Cut Pro data. Next, my capture card. I have the, let me get the name right. I use a AverMedia Live Gamer Portable 2, which I bought for $139 last year. I don't believe this model is available anymore, but you can get the AverMedia Gamer Portable 2 Plus, which actually streams up to 4K. Part of the reason why I bought this capture card when I did is because I had read that it was easy to use with laptops, which it absolutely is. Mine personally only streams up to 1080p HD with 60 frames per second, but with the Switch being pretty much the only thing I stream, it isn't higher quality than that. So that wasn't an issue for me at all when I bought mine. The Plus version does go up to 4K, so if you want to be streaming Xbox One, I was about to say 360, who am I, what year is it, or PlayStation 4 off of it, not a problem. How this capture card works is I plug the HDMI cable from my Switch into the capture card, I plug a HDMI cable from the capture card into my TV, so that lets me see the gameplay, hear the gameplay audio, while it is still also being routed through the capture card, which then connects to my laptop via a USB cable. It is super simple. I don't think I had to download any sort of software for it to connect to my computer, and it really easily appears in my OBS. Have no issue with it. I really like it, and it's definitely not a super expensive option. I think the current model is $120, so that's gonna be the most expensive thing you'll need to buy if you don't already have the laptop, the Switch, and the TV, which are the other hypothetical three big things. I also recommend getting a USB hub. This isn't a requirement if you have enough USB ports. My Mac only has two USB ports, so I got a USB hub, which my capture card, my microphone, my webcam, and a portable hard drive all connect to. The portable hard drive isn't a necessity for this setup. I just need it for video editing. The laptop that I use was the Logitech 1080p camera. It's now branded as AngleTube 920, something like that. It's a $40 webcam. It's on Amazon, 1080p. I don't know what exists out there in terms of webcams right now in terms of cheaper or more expensive. I think there's a Logitech one that's about on par with that, but I haven't had any problem with the quality. I find what really helps the most when it comes to webcams is having good lighting. I'm sure you've heard this before if you are researching into streaming. Lighting can help a lot. In my case, right now I use a ring light. This is an 8-inch ring light. It was about $30 on Amazon. I've also heard that getting a panel LED light and mounting that behind your setup in front of you is a really good option to my you might want to look into. I have links to both the one, the ring light I have, as well as the panel light in the description. The ring light, it works best if you can get the ring around the camera in the middle. The way I have it set up, I can't quite, so my lighting isn't exactly optimal when I'm streaming. But it's something I am working on and working towards improving. The microphone I use a USB mic. Let's see if I can pick it up and not knock over everything. This bad boy, I've had this since 2017. It works surprisingly well for being a $30 USB mic I bought in 2017. I've been using this in all of my app gameplay videos as well as on my streams since I've been streaming. You can hear the quality of the audio for yourself if you watch any of my Royal Chaos videos or even back to my Dream Girlfriend videos. I was using this mic to make those. With USB mics, you don't have the same customization option as you do with the more expensive non-USB options, but this is your simplest option for if you don't know a lot about audio, you want something that's gonna work and that you can plug in, simply make a few adjustments. That's gonna be stuff that's just gonna take time and messing around with. I am not an expert, so I cannot give solid input on that. This microphone is no longer available, but I found an equivalent that I think is probably on par in terms of price and quality based off of reviews. So I put a link to that as well as a link to everything else I've talked about in this video in the description. I also have a really small, I think it's about 20-inch TV on my desk. This basically acts as my second monitor. If I were to have a PC with a dual monitor setup where one screen is recording and running OBS and another screen is the gameplay, that's kind of how my setup works. My TV is dedicated to showing just the Switch gameplay, and then my laptop just runs OBS. Moving on to what software I use. If I haven't already mentioned it in this video, I use OBS. It is a free software. It is available for Macs. As far as I know, Streamlabs OBS is still not available for Macs, so that's not even an option for us. But the basic OBS has a black logo. Super simple, super easy to use, so much information online in terms of how to use it. So if you ever have a problem, you can pretty much always Google it and find a video tutorial on how to do things on it. For my elements, like my chat box and my alerts, I like using Streamlabs. While I can't use their OBS version, I can still use their elements that are available for free. They're pretty customizable, all things considered, easy to use, super easy setup actually, so I highly recommend that. Again, that's another thing that you can easily Google if you're struggling to set it up yourself. I made my own stream layout because I'm extra and have access to Photoshop, which I also have experience with putting things together in kind of a graphic design sense. But if you don't have experience with that, you can definitely find layouts for free on Stream Elements or Stream Labs, I think, also has free layouts available. Or you can also commission one from someone, check on Twitter, check on Fiverr, try and figure out people that you like art style of, and commission them, support artists. The art I use on my stream is from Aloha Sushi Corp, which I also credit on my stream layout because they are amazing. I love their artwork so much. They did my sheep artwork as well as my like profile picture, which is no longer accurate now that I let my natural hair color back into the party. I highly recommend commissioning artists if you can afford it to make cool things, because that's their job, to make cool things, and it kind of helps make your stream look fresh. I stream on Twitch. I use the stream manager on there to monitor my chat and to make sure everything is working okay. I haven't had too many issues other than sometimes having frame rate problems, in which I really just had to restart my laptop. Everything is fine, or make sure I have enough files cleared out of Final Cut, which most of you probably won't have to deal with, but like Final Cut takes up a delicious amount of space on my laptop. When I finish my streams, I really like to add a custom thumbnail immediately on the video. That also makes it really easy if I'm importing it over to YouTube. I don't highly recommend importing every stream over to YouTube. It kind of kills your YouTube channel if you're like me and you're slowly killing your YouTube channel. I'm doing my best. Yeah, I also recommend if you can get some like cute lights and stuff that go in your background. That's also great. People love that if they get a look at something interesting. I usually try not to have mine on fade the entire time, but looks like that's what I've done. I also have my little rainbow. I think that pretty much sums up my Twitch setup, my streaming setup. If you have any questions, put them in the comments below. Again, this is not a professional streaming setup. This is a like, hey, I have some of these parts. I have a MacBook. Can I stream with it? Set up. So yeah, I hope that this is helpful, informative. Again, if you have any questions, feel free to put them in the comments below. I've also compiled a link to all of the products I've talked about in this video. They're not affiliate links or anything. I get no money. Don't worry. Just like my videos if you want to support me. I'm going to go ahead and leave things off here. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a like, give it a comment, subscribe if you'd like to see more, follow me on Twitch, and I will see you all next time. Bye-bye. Have a good Junko. Bye-bye.